Hello friends and welcome to my YouTube channel Way to Success. So friends, I am on the verge of completing this topic called your enzyme linked receptors. We have already discussed the receptor tyrosine kinases and tyrosine kinase associated receptors in my previous videos, right? So the last topic of this discussion would be your serine threonine kinase receptor. It is also a kind of your enzyme linked receptor. But throughout we were reading that there is a kind of kinases which are present in your enzyme linked receptors, and that is your tyrosine kinases, right? But now we are going to see that there are two other kind of kinases which are present in your receptor. They are already linked to your receptor and they will get phosphorylated, and after that your signal transduction will be carried out. So everything is same, but the thing is, you have a particular receptor that is already contain your kinases, and that to your serine threonine kinases instead of your tyrosine kinases, right? So first of all, we will see what are the ligands which generally bind to these kind of receptors. These are your TGF beta superfamily members, and these members consist of three classes. First one is your TGF beta, that is your transforming growth factor beta, your activins, and BMPs, that is your bone morphogenetic proteins, right? We have two classes of your serine threonine receptors, type 1 and type 2, and these two classes are present in the form of dimers. They are already in the form of your dimers form. They are present in the plasma membrane, and they are single transmembrane just like your receptor tyrosine kinases, right? But they are present in the dimer form, and that too homodimers. You can see there are two kind of your receptors, and they both are present in the dimeric forms, right? And both of these types will work together to complete the rest of your pathway. So here you can see there are two kind of pathways, there are two kind of receptors, type 2 receptor and type 1 receptor, right? I have written this in this form, like first I have written the 2 and then 1. I will discuss why I have written this. So here are your two kind of receptors. They have the serine threonine kinase domains present at your cytosolic domain. They also have one extracellular domain, which is your ligand binding domain, one transmembrane alpha helices, and your cytosolic domain containing the serine threonine kinases, right? Whenever your ligand binds with your receptor, one more thing guys, your ligands which are binding to this kind of receptors, they are also present in the dimer conditions, right? That is not a single protein, but it is in a dimeric form. So what happens when the ligand bind to your receptor 2? First, receptor 2 will be activated with the help of ligand binding. And once this receptor will be activated, this one is in homodimer form right now, and whenever this will react or activate with the help of your ligand, it gets phosphorylated and will lead to the phosphorylation of your type 1 receptor. And ultimately, these homodimers, both of these homodimers will dimerize with each other and they form a tetramer, right? So obviously this phosphorylation is taking place at their serine threonine kinases, residues, serine threonine residues with the help of your kinases. So we will going to see that how this pathway is basically working with the help of a simple example of your SMAD pathway, right? So here it is, your SMAD pathway. First of all, what is a SMAD, right? We are discussing a thing and we should know every general point about that particular topic which we are concerned about to learn it in a better way, right? So first of all, what a SMAD is? SMAD is a kind of your protein that is your transcription factor, right? It comes from two things, right? First one is your SMA proteins of your C. elegans and MAD proteins of your Drosophila, right? These kind of proteins are generally play an important role in regulating the cell development and growth of these particular organisms, right? Especially if we take an example of your SMAD4, it is a kind of your tumor suppressor gene, right? Here we can see two major pathways having two kind of ligands here and one here, right? But the pathway is same, only the difference is that they activate different kind of SMAD proteins in the cytosolic region, right? So what happens, activin and TGF beta, they will act on the receptor and they will activate the receptor 2. When this receptor 2 will be activated, it will lead to the phosphorylation of the serine threonine residues which are present on the receptor 1, right? Ultimately, what happens? This will directly phosphorylate one of your transcription factor that is already present in the cytosol, and that is your SMAD family proteins, right? Basically, your activin and TGF beta will activate SMAD2 and SMAD3, right? They will phosphorylate these SMAD proteins, and as soon as these SMAD proteins will get activated, they will released into the cytosol and form the dimer with another SMAD protein, that is your SMAD4, and this dimer, this phosphorylated dimer will translocate from the cytosol to the nucleus and will bind to a particular DNA sequence and lead to the transcription and regulation of your cell development and growth, right? Similarly, your bone morphogenetic proteins, they will also bind to these receptors and phosphorylate the receptor 2 first, and after this phosphorylation, receptor 2 will phosphorylate the serine threonine residues on the receptor 1, and this will lead to the phosphorylation of SMAD 1 and 5 and will be released from this cytosolic domain of your receptor into the cytosol, where it will dimerize with the SMAD4 protein, and ultimately the translocation of this dimer will lead to the nucleus, and there it will bind to the DNA and will lead to transcription. So that's all with your enzyme linked receptors, right? We are completed with this topic. In my next video, I'm going to explain you the ion receptors, right? Ion channel receptors. That will be the last topic of this series. So, if you guys still have any doubt about any of these topics we have completed till now, you can just ask me by commenting in the comment box. And till then, stay focused on your studies, please, because time is already very limited for your exams. So, stay focused and study hard, okay? If you like my videos, please give me a thumbs up and please share these videos with your friends, and please subscribe to my channel for more videos like this. Thank you so much.